trying to get one up.
Akwe, Akwene, this is Thunder Voice Osamequin here with Wampamequin Wampatuck. I'm here just asking them a few questions and concerns that I had for our indigenous Aboriginal Native community. And just want to see what his thoughts and views were. How you doing there, sir?
I'm doing very well, Akwe.
All right. For those that don't know who you are, can you just tell me a little bit about yourself and, you know, what do you do?
Akwe Akwene Wunikisuk. My name is Wampamequin Wampatuck. I come from the Mattakesa tribal community. I currently serve as a Mattakesa tribal leader in our community. Our traditional territories are Hingham, Hanson, Pembroke, Scituate, Norwell, Abington, Bridgewater, so on and so forth. We're throughout the southern, southeastern region of Massachusetts.
Oh, somewhere like Taunton or something?
Yes.
Okay. Taunton as well. All right, word. So one of my questions would be, what would be the ideal or primary form of identification for our indigenous peoples moving forward? And what would some of the ideas be for re-implementation, or the what they call implementation?
Okay, so for an ideal idea on what an identification would look like for indigenous peoples, I would say there would need to be one ideal primary source of identification for indigenous peoples that would serve as a right to travel, a boarding pass, a passport, and what have you. You know, the challenge, I would say, for implementation on such an identification would be the trickle effect on how the United States would dictate to their states policy change at a legislative level, and the implementation to their companies, their institutions and organizations. I think that the United States would need to consult with indigenous peoples to help in the implementation of policy change for these organizations and companies.
Nice. Okay. For our indigenous communities, where would you see us in like 10 years? Like, you know, I've seen a few things happening nationally, you know, for indigenous peoples and status Indians and non-status Indians and things like this. But where do you see us as an indigenous community in 10 years from now?
Great question, Thunder. In 10 years from now, I would like to see indigenous peoples working in conjunction with non-indigenous peoples to help sustain and preserve the culture and heritage of indigenous peoples for our future generations. I would like to see legislative processes being implemented and changed for indigenous peoples in 10 years.
Nice. I truly think that this is definitely a time of change. It's definitely a time of, you know, greatness for our people as Native people. What would be the most effective way to implement that change within indigenous communities?
Can you repeat that question?
Like, as far as the change goes, what would be like one of the most effective ways to, you know, come to the people with, you know,
yes,
in changing some of the things that maybe it would be something new, or it would be something that would scrap what is going on and bring forth something that was working, you know, in our past?
Yes. So I think one of the most effective mechanisms to see the change in the indigenous communities would be for indigenous peoples to work collaboratively with non-indigenous people. But indigenous peoples would have to find and utilize healing mechanisms that are traditional, that are from the elders, that are from their tribal communities, and that are ceremonial, to help the process of healing for a new tomorrow. Indigenous people would need to work in efforts to collaborate with non-Indigenous people to create a more sustainable and healthy environment for the human race.
I feel you with that one, Wampamequin. It's definitely important that Indigenous peoples and non-Indigenous peoples come to a agreement on the changes that need to be made in for the betterment of our nation, and people. What inspires you? I would like to know, sir, what inspires you, like, on a daily basis to do the work that you're doing, man, to keep going forward, to continue this great journey, for our Indigenous communities, and, like, nationally and globally? What inspires you to, like, keep going forward?
Great question, Thunder. What inspires me, I think, Thunder, is that when I wake up in the morning, I look into the mirror and I see an Indigenous person. And also, when I look into that mirror, I see the reflection of other Indigenous people who may not be able to voice their concerns and their issues. So when I look into that mirror, Thunder, I see someone who is an inspiration and also inspired by other Indigenous peoples. And that drives my passion to want to do whatever it is that I can do by implementing solutions for Indigenous peoples on a daily basis.
Nice. And truly, I appreciate, the diligence and the champion work, man, because I know it's not hard or easy, but, you make it seem easy sometimes, what I mean, with some of the things that I've seen you do in demonstration in court and certain things like that. It's very phenomenal, I have to tell you, man, My last question would be, what are some of your plans upon returning from the United Nations Forum on Indigenous Issues? Because I know that you're supposed to be going pretty soon here and going before the United Nations. And I just want to know, upon returning from this monumental goings, what do you have in store for us for the future?
So, I've been invited to serve as a representative of an NGO of the Southwest Native Cultures under the direction of Mr. Terry Sloan. And this year, the United Nations is dealing with peace and conflict resolution. My goal upon returning is to utilize the tools, the knowledge, the reports, and the networks that I can build to help come back to my local community and help in sustaining the cultural development and the traditional development of Indigenous communities as a whole.
Okay, nice, man. I really appreciate this time that, you've taken to get this to me, because I know that as well as I have concerns, I know that my people and our Indigenous community have concerns and would like to know what's going on with Wampamequin Wampatuck, So I put this together and we'll be getting this out, so that the community has a view on what's going on and what's important and how we feel, because I know we're not always seen, So I appreciate your time. To my people, I just want to say thank you very much to Botany, and signing off till next time. This is Thunder Voice Osamequin and Wampamequin Wampatuck.